My best wishes to you on the occasion of the 72nd anniversary of India's independence. Such occasions are important for assessing not only the transformations happening in our country, and there are many, but also for examining changes occurring at our institute. The biggest change at ISA in the past year is that in our academic program for undergraduates, the BSMS program. When I joined ISA in November 2017, it became clear to me very soon after talking to a wide cross-section of students and faculty members that it was time to examine whether the BSMS program needed tweaking or even more substantive change. The program was unique, with students learning in the classroom, from carrying out research projects, and from supervised reading projects. Any modification in an already successful program would have to be done with care. But it was clear that students wanted more rigor and more depth in the courses taught to them, and faculty members wanted to be able to teach more in depth and in scope. In any undergraduate program, it is important to have a good balance between depth and breadth. Breadth in education is important for many aspects of what we consider to be a good education. We want to teach our students to think about problems not just in a dry, analytical manner, but also to think in a manner that combines logic with imagination so that they have new ideas and paradigms to test. They need to learn to think in a manner that does not preclude questioning, not only of the subject matter, but also of their own scientific beliefs, assumptions, and conventions. They need to learn to think in a manner that leads to greater trust in their own abilities, so that they become convinced that they will always be able to learn new things on their own for the rest of their lives. A breadth in education makes students more balanced and leads to a better overall development of their character. It teaches them not only how complex science can be, but also how life itself is full of contradictions and is a constant struggle. A broad education is what provides the way forward for the many of our students who come to us as uncertain teenagers with minds that have not yet decided what they would want to do in the future when they leave the institute as young adults. ISER has always prided itself that it prepares students well for carrying out interdisciplinary research. The education required for carrying out path-breaking interdisciplinary research itself requires a fine balance between breadth and depth. Breadth in the form of exposure to and training in multiple subjects so that the student becomes familiar with and hence is not intimidated by any topic. Depth because interdisciplinary fields of research are invariably pushed forward by scientists who have depth and rigor in their training and thinking and hence are real experts in their chosen disciplines. The best interdisciplinary research requires someone who is a true expert in at least one discipline. We had an academic advisory committee working hard and long to come up with a new academic program after many discussions, some quite argumentative. Many of the distinctive features of the ISER Pune BSMS program have, of course, been retained, and the changes have allowed many of the concerns of students and faculty members to be addressed. The new curriculum for the new program has been developed under the oversight of our curriculum committee and the individual departments, with much hard work by many of our faculty members. I'm sure that the new academic program, which is being implemented from this year, will have the right balance of depth and breadth and will evolve into one of the best undergraduate programs anywhere. Of course, there is much left to be done for that to happen. We faculty members need to learn to teach even better so that we can even more successfully mentor our students and excite them to start loving topics they had no previous interest in. The Institute plans to have a Center for Teaching Excellence that would help our faculty members in this by introducing new pedagogical tools. We need to have programs in place that will teach students the enduring skills, including the essential skills to think well that they will need for the rest of their lives, as well as the soft skills that will help them move successfully from ISER to their next destination. We need to have better systems in place to help our students to find good positions when they leave here, for short periods or for good, whether in academic or industrial research, or in science education or science management or science communication, or anything else they become interested in during their stay at the Institute. The Institute is actively recruiting new faculty members in the humanities and has made plans to start activities in computer science, especially in artificial intelligence and data science. For accomplishing all this and for our academic programs to flourish, we will continue to need the continuing cooperation and enthusiastic support of all our staff, teaching as well as non-teaching. Fortunately, ISER Pune is an institute where this is never in short supply. I wish you all the best on this day of celebration of the independence of our country. Happy Independence Day. Thank you. Okay.